You guys good?
How's it going, Joe?
How's it going?
Good.
So you ever think you'd be back here doing media or open workouts?
Kind of. I mean, like, the second UFC said they're coming back to Boston, I thought it was a good chance. You know, I've been gearing up to get a fight earlier anyways, so it just worked out perfect.
Did it have to be Boston or could have been
no,
Tampa?
It's great to fight Boston. Like, I love being here. I'm really excited about being here for everyone, but it wouldn't have mattered. If I fought in Tampa, if I fought something in Vegas, like, it's always just extra nice being in Boston.
How many people have asked you if Friday's your last fight?
A lot. Even, like, to the last fight, everyone just assumed I was done, you know? And it wasn't that I was done. It was that I need to take some time and just take a, you know, step back, reevaluate what I was doing, change things up a little bit. So we did that. I've had a lot of time now. It's been, I think it was like April last year.
Yeah.
I've had a lot of time to kind of reevaluate, kind of look at things, and I feel good.
Is this one of those take it fight by fight, or do you plan on continuing to fight after Friday? I'm sure you get asked that question a lot, too.
We always take it fight by fight. Sure. You know, I can think of a whole lot of things that are a lot worse than having my last fight be in Boston.
Sure.
You know what I mean? So. But we'll see how it goes. You know, I feel really good. I don't feel old. Like, everyone's always saying, like, oh, you're old, like, 35. But, you know, I understand I've had a lot of fights in UFC. But I think we're a little bit smarter than most people. Like, we take a lot of time off with hurt the head injuries and being hired. So, I don't know, we'll see.
Does it just matter on the performance? Like, you get in there, get in and out quick, another fight, but another war.
Maybe. I mean, I'm not dead set on it. Like, I have a gym in Easton, Massachusetts.
Yeah.
So it's like half hour from here. Like, the gym does well. We're packed all the time. Like, so I don't need to fight. It's just that I was really happy with how the last fight went. I think that could be the last one. This may be the last one, but not necessarily.
What does it mean to share this card and then just share the open room with Randy Costa's been with you for so long?
Oh, it's great, you know. Like, we got a lot of guys that train with us, like, all the time. You know, like, it's Randy, but we also have Mike Rodriguez, Calvin Cater, Rob Font, a whole bunch of other guys, Peter Barrett. We got a whole bunch of guys, so it's great that, you know, to be on here with Randy. I was glad he was able to, like, come here today. That's boundless. It's awesome. You know, I've been, you know, like, Randy started with me, like, when he was, you know, so much younger. It's like a little kid almost, you know, and just he's just such a pillar of the gym. You know, he's one of those guys, like a cornerstone. Like, anyone's scary, he's down to spar, he's down to wrestle, he's down to do whatever, help people out with diet, help people with whatever. So, like, I'm glad I can help out Randy, but I'm really glad I could, you know, get him in the
game. Did you expect this to happen for Randy so quickly?
Yeah, I mean,
he's so pretend.
So Randy was like the biggest wimp like 2 years ago. Right, like, we wanted him to fight, like, he's doing hard rounds with, like, me and Rob Font and Calvin Cater and all these other guys that are really good, and he's doing great against them, but he didn't want to fight. It was like, I don't know, nerves or what, but you know, it was like pulling teeth to get him to fight. We get him to fight, he bangs up 3 wins, we knew he was going to the UFC. So, like, it was kind of the plan all worked out perfectly the way it happened, you know, but Randy's really good.
Talk about this. You get Jonathan Pearce, he's a newcomer coming off the Contender Series UFC debut. What have you learned about him for this process? Did you do much about him in the fight with Iowa?
I knew a little bit about him, but not a ton. You know, it's like there's so many fights all the time. Like, I used to be like, you know, everything about everyone all the time. Like, everyone in my weight class, people above me, people below me, I knew everyone. Now there's so many fights, it's tough to track everything. I remembered him as the kid that, you know, got his jaw broken really bad, you know, before he got fighting his pro. So I remembered his story a little bit, but I didn't remember a whole lot about him. We went back and watched and broke down tape, and, you know, my coach did a really good job. You know, I think we got him a good game plan for what's going on, but we'll see.
We'll talk about your coaching, obviously. Is that something that you consider when you're making the decision how long you want to do this? You know, some guys don't have anything at the end of their career. You have a really good thing going. You seem to have a staple in New England.
Yeah, I mean, we do really well. You know, like, the biggest thing is we have, like, really good culture in our gym. Like, it's like, we got guys that are very, very good, but we always talk about, like, don't break your toys, right? You know, you need to keep your people happy and healthy and prepared well. You can't have, like, you have one person that's like a bad egg. It just ruins it for everyone else. Just the whole entire thing comes crumbling down. So we have a really good kind of stable of guys there, all good training partners. So I don't have to come here and fight. I could focus on my gym more. My gym would probably do a little bit better if I did focus on my gym more. But for like the last 10 months or so, I've been so focused on fighting. I'm doing it because I want to do it, not because I have to.
You talked about your last fight, obviously, you want to put that in the rear view mirror.
Yep.
What were the adjustments that you made that made you feel like you could fight? Was it mental, physical?
So sometimes you just get comfortable doing the things you've been doing. That was my 26th fight in the UFC. And, you know, I kind of set on, like, the thing I was doing. I knew what I was doing for my strength conditioning. I knew what I was doing for, you know, jiu-jitsu. I knew what I was doing for boxing and everything else. You know, so we changed out a few things. I don't want to get into too much, but a big part of it was I started going to Skill Strength with Mike Perry. And I drive, like, an hour and a half. Twice a week. I leave so early to get there. Ends up being like a 5 or 6 hour ordeal. But it's important. You know, it was one of those things where, like, it was, and I kind of knew I needed to do it before, but it was just, it's such a big, it's like, oh, I can spend 10 hours doing other things, or I can spend 10 hours going to strength and conditioning place. And, you know, before I didn't think it was maybe as necessary, but after my last fight, I was sure that it was like a necessary change. So we did it. I sucked it up. And I wasn't happy about driving so far, but I want to be as prepared as possible, so I did what was necessary.
I know you said you weren't overly familiar with Pearce when he was offered to you, but have you had time to kind of look him over, research him? You know, what do you expect to see out of him?
There's a lot of things that I'm thinking about, but I don't want to talk about it. You know what I mean? Like, you know, he's a long-range kickboxer. Like, a lot of volume. Kid's tough. Super tough. Anyone that gets this point is super tough. Had a great fight in the contender series. I'm expecting a tough fight, you know. But I know where he's coming from. Like, I was the kid that was, you know, the underdog. You know, he's not as much of an underdog. But being an underdog, coming up, fighting someone with a lot of experience, you know, fighting a veteran, and I understand how you make a name off of that. You know, so I'm very committed to not letting that happen to me on Friday night.
You just shared your moment with Brady Costa.
Yep.
Is that your idea to let him get some experience?
I'm always happy to have him. Yeah, I mean, for sure. I mean, I try to get all my guys involved in everything. You know, it's not just like this. It's everything. Right? I want, you know, we have like, I have a girl, Erin Johnson, who we think is going to be very, very good. Right? I have her come and she corners. She gets in the back room. She corners for fighters, so she gets to see like what's going on in the back room. You know, I don't want things to be like the first time the spotlight's on you to be the first time people are there and experience it. You know? So we're the same thing. We get all of our fighters that are going to maybe fight our amateurs. They start cornering for our fighters. You know? A lot of times their corner is not like necessarily, you know, super necessary. So we try to, you know, kind of bring them along. And that was what worked out well for me. Like, I was cornering guys, and it helps with just therapy, seeing how other people deal with things. And, you know, so I'm pumped that Randy got to come here. Now, when he has his own, you know, open workout, he won't be so nervous about it. He'll know what's going on. He'll know what to expect.
You mentioned all this list of fighters.
Yep.
And you talk about training with them. You do a lot more than training. You do coaching. How much, you know, time can you spend training yourself, but also coaching Randy and Kyle and all these guys.
It depends what's going on. Like, when, you know, for like Rob Font, for example, right? This camp, he was a training partner. I wasn't coaching Rob. Like, I was sparring with Rob. Like, I was getting good work with Rob. Like, it's, you know, there's other times when I'm working on things with him where I'm like, okay, I'm taking a lot of time and I'm doing a lot of like very specific drilling. And I'm not necessarily trying to win. I'm trying to make him struggle and make him work a little bit. But I wasn't trying to win. You know, so that's the only real difference from my perspective for, you know, being the coach versus the training partner. You know, like, there's, you know, Rob does things better than me. Calvin does things better than me. So like I learn from them, I take from them, but I probably give them a little more than they give me, but it's good work all the way around.
When you wake up Friday morning, are you more nervous for your fight or your teammates' fight?
I'll probably be more focused on my fight, I think. You know, usually it's the opposite, but for like, you know, basically the last like month and a half, I try to kind of like remove myself a little bit from like we talked a little bit about like the planning and things like that, like what's going on, but I've kind of been hands off for the most part. It's just too much sometimes. Like, you just get too emotionally invested. So I'm trying to not care about Randy's fight so much. I obviously do, but I'm trying to not get super into it and just kind of stay focused on myself.
If this is your last fight, you're on the fence. If this is your last fight, what do you think your legacy is in sport?
I think unfortunately we know this guy didn't have cardio sometimes because I've gotten tired. But I think a lot of it's come from, you know, you take damage and your gas tank doesn't last as long. But I think I had a lot of really memorable fights, you know, good or bad. You know, like, I've had a lot of bonuses. I think I'm remembered as that. I think people are going to remember that I wore so many different hats. Like, you know, I've been coaching and cornering and everything, you know, while I'm still fighting. And, I don't know. I think people will look back fondly on it, but I'm not super concerned. Like, I'm happy that people enjoy watching me fight.
Are you going to take a moment to think, like, you know, Boston got a long way since
you
fighting
yeah.
McCullough.
Yep.
Or, you know, game one, just supposed to lose the gym.
Yeah,
over.
Yep,
no.
Yeah, yep, for sure. You know, it's crazy. Like, I think about, like, you know, like fighting in, like, small little, like, bars and clubs where you get kicked out of, like, a little sidebar that we're warming up in. Yeah, 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 yep. It's, you know, from Club Lido up in Revere to the Rosenbaum in Taunton, you know what I mean? Like, all over the place. Yep. So it's just, there's so many good memories about how it's kind of changed over the years. Like even, like, this week, like, you know, like we have, like, trifecta, you know, meals. For all the food, like, they literally, I show up, they give me all my food, I'm doing it, they give me all, oh, here, have some water, have this, it's just, like, it's so different than it was in the beginning, even when I got in the UFC, it's, like, it's night and day. Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.
Not a problem.